Chapter 9 of Herland, called Our Relations and Theirs, is all about education in Herland. It begins by addressing more of the differences between this country and the men's country, the idea of a singular home, and the total lack of vices. And Terry struggled with that. Van's own issues with the things he finds unsatisfying lead him to seek out his tutor for more in-depth answers. She explains at great length how education functions in this country. Again, Van compares it to the world he has known, and he finds this country superior. He realizes, as he learns of the women's very immersive, hands-on approach to education, that it's actually a system that educates while being pleasurable, a concept he finds hard to comprehend. He defines the education system in Herland as education for citizenship. Here again, the reader sees Charlotte Perkins Gilman's philosophies as foundational to understanding her landmark novel, Herland. In this case, the focus is on education. Her holistic approach to education is a logical outgrowth of being raised in a family of intellectuals. Gilman, as with many of the topics covered in Herland, uses this opportunity to expand on what she thinks education should do and how it should be structured. What would a best-case educational system be? Like Jane Addams, who founded Hull House, where the author stayed briefly when she was traveling and lecturing after she was divorced, Gilman thought education was absolutely vital to democracy. She believed that women especially needed access to higher education and critical thinking. Considering Gilman's own educational theories that women ought to be receiving a better quality of education and that education was about the society, not the individual itself, it's not surprising to see such a lengthy discussion of those ideas in Herland.